Okay, this is my air condition of one of my property, and it doesn't work. So what I want to show you here, how to address the problem with this air condition before you call it to anyone that can rip you off. So the first thing I took that one out, that is the breaker switch here. So I'll put it in, I want to show you what's happening here. You can hear the noise. Now, this meaning that the fan or one of the things cannot work because it tried to move but it cannot move. So let me try to move it. You know what I'm doing now? I'm trying to move it with this stick. This is the stick I try to move it to prove you that you're missing the startup capacitors. Here's the stuff. Here's the air condition, and you can hear the zoom. What I'm doing, I will try to move it with a stick. You can see the stick here? So as you can see, it's starting to running because I give him a push. That meaning the startup capacitor is gone. And so you can see it's actually starting to work. And remember, we cannot come every time that the air condition doesn't work to start it with a stick, remember? And by the way, in this air condition, two things doesn't work, the fan and the compressor. So I have here a capacitor to replace it, and I want to show you how I'm doing it. So the first thing you're doing when you're starting working with air condition, it's a very simple thing. You can go to the breaker switch and turn it off, but any air condition have to have a breaker switch next to it. You see, I'm taking it and I just pull it. And that is the breaker switch, you see? Now no electricity can come here, and now it can work safely. So let me show you what's happening here. So the first thing we have to do, you see the power is coming from here, there is no power now. So this is the box that the electrical unit, the electrical utility is here. I mean, we need to open for that four screw. This is the first screw. It's actually a metal screw. One screw. It's a very simple thing to do. Two screws. Here is the third screw. See how long it takes me? It takes me less than a minute or two to remove one screw. The box. Yeah, it's a metal box. Okay. So already four screws has been gone, and now just to pull it. It'll be tricky, but don't worry, we'll be successful. Okay, so that is the. So you can see here, if you're getting close, see, here is the capacitor really. This is the capacitor that I suspect is blow up. Okay. So I'm going to remove it, and I'm going to test it also with a capacitor tester to see if that one is gone. But I know it's gone because, as you can see, I tried to start up the capacitor fan, it didn't work, I had to push it with a stick. That meaning I give him a push, I give him a startup capacitor. So what I'm doing now, I actually remove the insulation from this capacitor. As you can see, it's the original capacitor was oval, and this is a circle. I put it like 5 years ago. I have the same things, and a person wants for that to replace it. He told me first that the fan gone, blow up, and the capacitor we didn't even talk about, and he wants like $300 or $400 with capacitor. It costs like $10. So from that one, I want to help you here that you want to save a lot of money and aggravation. Other people really want to replace your compressor also. So if you look at this capacitor, you see I'm touching it with these things, so it might be a voltage here. It may be charged. I'm going to short it very soon. But I tell you, there's a three of them here. It's actually dual capacitor. One capacitor is for the fan, the other capacitor is for the compressor. I suspect the two capacitors gone, went, And remember, when it's gone, usually it's actually a little bit expanded, the capacitor, and it looks like it's expanded, so I can remove it and I replace it with other capacitor. But let me show you how. So the first thing I'm doing, I'm going to short the capacitor, you see, because it might be charged, and you really don't want to deal with it because it gives you a big zap. Let me see. See, here's the first thing I'm actually shorting. So you see, it was a zap here. And that is another one. We really need to short it before we're working in there, because then you're going to fly. Okay, so both of them are shorted now. And there is no problem whatsoever. So what I'm going to look here, this, the brown is for the fan, you see? Because if you look at here, there is a fan, there is something called Rheem. The Rheem is going to the compressor, which is the orange here, and that is, so you can see there are two of them, it's common. The C is the common. Nobody confuse you, it's a common. Okay, so you have actually two capacitors here, one of them for the fan and one for the compressor. So I will remove it now, and I will replace it with a other capacitor that I purchased. So before I'm moving them, I move the wires, I just mark each wire where it's going. So I know these two of them going to the center is important, okay? And here I have one, I lift it out marked, so that the brown is going to the fan. So it's already removed. This going to the compressor, and I'm going to remove it with pliers. Don't push the wire, because you'll cut the wire. Don't push from the wire. You have to take it from here, you see? Where is the connector here? Kind of a metallic connector. If you cannot take it with your hand, try use a plier or some other tools to do it. So here's the plier. This is kind of a long nose plier. You take it from here, you see what I'm doing? And I will push it slowly out. Because there's a wire here, and be careful from there not to remove it. And this is other wire. Okay? So this is the capacitor that is actually gone. And I want to show you how I'm testing it. So I ever took a, that's the old capacitor, and that is the new capacitor I want to show you. It's a tightened capacitor. This capacitor is called, okay, Artes capacitor, what it's called. That is a rat capacitor, and that is a Titan capacitor. And I purchased it, let me show you from where I purchased it. It's from a company called Gringer Company, okay? So this capacitor costs $10. Okay, and I want to show you how I'm testing it, just to show you. See, this is a tools. Okay, it can test capacitor, it can test many things, but also capacitors. I put it on the capacitor, it's EAP here. And I'm taking this two and I put it between. If I put it here, touch it, zero, nothing. Okay, between that and that, you can see zero. Okay, so what happening here, the capacitor was disconnected. Zero capacitance, it was blow up, okay, this capacitor. If I take it to a new capacitor, here's the new capacitor we have here. So as you can see, from the C, I'm always tested from the C, which is in the center. Okay, from the C to that one, I'll put it like this. And as you can see, let me touch it properly. That should be actually 3.036. Let me do that again. 3.3 C, that's 3 microfarad. And for the M, should be 35. So let's see, wait. 34.65 microfarad. The other one is 0. So you can see here, when I purchase this capacitor, I know it should be 35 capacitor to the compressor, which is M. And 3 microfarad to the fan. How do I know about it? I look at the old capacitor, and when I look at the old capacitor that was there, If you look at it, you can see that the old capacitor is 35 microfarad 3. Usually, 99% of the cases, the lower microfarad going to the fan, which is the high microfarad going to the compressor, because the compressor needs more power to work, to start, okay? So without that, these will not start. So remember, I tested it, and I can also see this capacitor is a little bit expanded himself, so it doesn't work a lot. So we can really throw it, correct? There, put it there just for a moment. And now I'm going to take the new capacitor here. Here it's a new capacitor, and I want to show you how I'm going to connect it. It's a very easy work, and you will see everything work properly as it should. And I saved to myself thousands of dollars, because usually most of the people are not honest. They will try to sell you a new air condition, or they will try to replace compressor or fan, which cost you $1,000. That's the price. So if you ask what is this, this is the contactor, okay, that connects. So there's a new capacitor, it never be connected. So remember, in the capacitor we have common, we have fan, and we have term, which is going to the compressor. You can see here, it's probably like that. Okay, so if you can see it here, you can see three characters. Okay, let me show it like that. This is the fan, this is the common, there is a sear, and that is the Rheem. Okay, and that's what I'm doing. The Rheem is the compressor. So I'm going again, I'm going to take this, and gently I push it from this connector. Don't touch it here, because you can maybe disconnect it. Okay, and now I take the fan, which is the brown wire. I put it here, okay? And this wire, both of them going to the common. Okay, I don't want to tell you all the electronics behind it. I know the electronics. Okay, but I don't want to explain to you. It's not really matter in this issue. The issue is to put them together. So now I really connect everything together. But before I'm going to put it here where its location should be. See, there is a special location in for him. Okay, I can put it inside. I really want to protect it using an insulation. See that insulation? Just put around there. I don't want any water or something to go inside. I can go without it, but you know, it's very, very good to protect these metals, these issues, okay? So I always use an isolation. This is black tape for electrical. And I'm going to put it now around the stuff just to make it sure it will never be shorted. So to do it, I'm actually going to use, see what I'm doing? I'm actually just cover it all around with insulation, okay? Okay, now, easy to cut it. So I cut it, and now I'm going to put on top of it, okay? I really want to cover all of it with insulation paper. Okay, this is a specially for electrical device to insulate electrical stuff. There probably was a rubber before here, and the rubber was disappeared, special rubber for it. So if you have the rubber, use the rubber. If you don't, really make what I'm doing here, and that will save the life of the capacitor for probably will linger the life of the capacitor to maybe 5 to 6 years. This capacitor, all these capacitors have life expectation of 5 to 6 years usually. And usually 90% of the cases when the air condition doesn't work, doesn't start, it's to do with these dual capacitors. Remember it. Because on a single phase, you have to give a push to the motor, to the fan. If you have three phase, no problem. If you have one phase, that would be working. You're working one phase, 220 volt. You have to give it a push, which means the capacitor is a startup, or some people call it a run-up capacitor. It's a startup capacitor, really. Okay. So yes, I did it here, and what I'm doing now, I'm going to just push it here inside. Okay, so I push it here inside. This one will work here with no really problem. So now I want to show from close what's going on. As you can see, here is the capacitor with the black insulation. It's already been connected, and you can see it's inside. And listen to that, I put here a little bit space. You can see the space. I didn't insert everything, which means cover it with everything, because if it's going to be a moisture inside, it will dry out by getting out. So you don't want really moisture to go inside without getting out of this capacitor, because then it's shorted. So it's nice to leave a little bit of space here, like I left there. This is space here. And if moisture will accumulate it, it will dry out in a heat. So remember that. So now what is left for us is just to close this box. It's not going to be very simple. I will close it now, and I can show you how to close box like that. So this is the box. Sure, I'm taking it out. You see, there is a warning here, and there is all the details, so it should be on the top like that. And then you just put it here. It's quite simple. Okay, and you always need to give it a little bit of push. If it doesn't go, you see, I push it like that. Give it a box, and you can start putting the screws where they need it. Okay, with your screwdriver, just to attach the screw as you want. You see, it's very, 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 very easy to do. There is not a lot of problem here. You have to put the second one. Okay. So the temperature now is 92 degrees, and it's very humid, and it's really. That's the second screw, and we have another two screws. The screws, one is here. Okay, and the other one is here. So that is the way. Let me close it, and I'll continue with the show you how it's working. Just let me close it now. So this one already closed, and now I'm closing the other one, that one, the last one. And now everything is perfectly done. Okay, just make sure everything is okay here. Remove any not necessary, even this tool is not necessary now for it. And remember, this is the switch that I can actually see if the air condition working or not. So I'm going to put this switch now and see what happened. Okay, so let's see what happened. I'm going to put it now. And as you can see, it starts immediately with no stick and no problem. So now the air conditioner, you can hear how it's working. Before, there was no noise. So the compressor is working perfectly, and the fan is working very good. So work is done. And remember, before you call into any technician and stuff, remember the dual capacitor, that is the most culprit in this issue with the air condition. Thank you very much for watching this video.